If you are liberal, what is your most conservative opinion? As a trans man who leans pretty far left, I don't think someone should be ridiculed for bottoming your gender. For eons, people have been given context clues, hair length, facial hair, etc., and made assumptions. It does not mean people are intentionally hurting you by doing this. Edited wording for clarity. Yes. God, I love it when people say this. I support people who are trans. And most of my trans friends have this same kind of view. People inherently bottom things when they first meet them. And the best way to get someone to respect your identity is to respectfully let them know your gender identity and not ridicule them for getting it wrong the first time. I very much appreciate this point of view. I was at a wedding recently here in the Deep South, and a friend's teenage child who I knew as a young lady when she was little appeared to have transitioned. Obvious use of men's clothing. Some surgery to remove breasts. And possibly even some facial hair additions. And since I knew we would be interacting throughout the evening, I just straight asked him his preferred pronouns. He confirmed it was him and that his name was now Keaton. I was terrified that he would be upset or insulted. But he actually smiled so big and seemed to genuinely happy that I would ask for clarity and show deference to his preferences. I think PPL try too hard to be politically correct on everything, but they don't actually understand what they're talking about. I'd rather people be blatantly ignorant than convince themselves they're not by posting about it on Instagram. Right. It's fine to not understand and be up to date on everything. Not everyone follows the latest progressive movement. If it's your thing, awesome. Doesn't have to be everyone's thing. This is exactly what I came here to say. This movement by white Americans to remove gender-based words in Spanish is so ignorant. Please stop with the Latinx. Because you would completely have to overhaul most of the language to accommodate for their feelings. An overwhelming majority of Spanish speakers don't use it or feel it's necessary. This is something both my right-wing and left-wing family members can all agree on. Liberals tear each other apart for not being perfect instead of helping each other try to learn. I'm not at all here for that. If you see someone you know acting poorly, having a real conversation about why you feel that's hurtful is going to stick better than shaming. Close second, virtue signaling. I don't have the time for that. I've heard the left described as a circular firing line. Everyone looking inwards at each other and infighting rather than realizing they're aligned on the bigger issues and focusing on them. Pretty accurate, I think. This. I'm all the way liberal, but I also have a brain and understand nuance. I fit that the two biggest problems are the liberals, as if we are some monolithic entity, agreeing which is the thing we are meant to be most upset about. And the worst crime, not being upset in the correct way. This does lead to a binary for against, and I've had arguments with people I basically agree with because I have not agreed in the correct manner, or with the same fervor. I tend to find those people actually undermine the cause somewhat. Frick off. We're the Judean People's Front. Very much on the left liberal. But I believe that people are responsible for their own triggers rather than everyone around them needing to watch every word they say. I think we coddle people too much sometimes. Edit. To add liberal. Maybe it's just me, but when people censor words, example, ape, it makes me think about the word even more, because now I have to understand the missing letter, or maybe that makes me notice the word more, so it does the opposite of what it should do. I'm kind in the middle. Basically, graphic descriptions, depictions of wars and rape should give people a heads up, but a lot of people are like, this depicts an unpleasant experience I also had and freak out. No matter how many minorities you identify with, you are not and should not act as if you are untouchable when you do wrong or just in butthole. Some criminals cannot be rehabilitated. They should stay in prison permanently. Also that certain crimes need much harsher sentences. Please be aware I live in New Zealand, not America. People don't go to jail here for 99 years for having some drugs. While I agree completely, the way the American prison system works, it's not meant to rehabilitate people at all. In the American prison system, no one gets rehabilitated. It's designed to keep the prisoners coming back. Do you know how hard it is to get a decent job when you have a criminal record? Now imagine you just got out of prison and have no income. You either become homeless, or resort to an illegal activity like selling drugs, prostitution to pay your bills, And I'm not saying no one comes out of prison rehabilitated, because some people see the light and make a huge change in their lives to get on the right track. But that is never a result of prison, but rather that individual deciding to make a change in their life. For America, and many other parts of the world, it is also common practice for women to receive lesser sentences for committing the exact same crimes that a man does. Like, to the letter, the same crime. But the sentencing will almost always be lighter. This is such a refreshing thread. Press F5 to make it even more refreshing. It is. I see myself as progressive liberal, but I agree with pretty much all of the opinions here, and it's making me confused lol. It's perfectly okay for sex to be a private thing. I'm sex positive. I want proper sex education, but the trend of sexualizing everything and being out there and explicit about what and how you like to frick could be toned down. I don't mind sex positive open attitudes one bit, but I hate it when people claim it's always important to be open about your sex life. I don't want to do that, and it's not because I'm prude. It's simply because I like keeping it tiny, between me and my partner. Feel free to tell me about your ventures, but I'm not gonna share mine. That makes neither of us wrong. I'm not a prude during everyday conversations. But there's just something very different about sex showing up in a role-playing game outside of situations where it was an established part of the campaign beforehand. I've had a really uncomfortable session where I had my character confronted with both a dragon trying to frick me and a forest deity whose penis was described in detail when we were in battle. I think there should be more trade schools and apprenticeships. That probably would seem conservative to some people. But many smart people sometimes do not fit in well at college. I think you'd find loads of normal liberal and conservative people who'd agree with this. It's more the establishment that pushes the go to college or flip burgers for the rest of your life mentality. Union trade schools and apprenticeships are plentiful. The problem is, back in the day, the government pushed the you got to go to college. Get a degree. Then you can get a good job. They made the tradesman image as dirty and low-ical, but I work in the union trades, and I'm sitting here in the house in Bort while my friends with their degrees are living with mom and dad at 35 years old. Promote the skilled trade schools more than university degrees. Worries about cultural appropriation are bullshit at least half the time. I understand if you don't want white girls dressing up like geishas because they think it's funny. But musicians and artists have been stealing ideas from everywhere forever, and that's how we wound up with jazz and hip-hop and other great things. Critics who tell you how to do art often don't do art very well. There's a group of Samoan men from New Zealand who love to sing traditional Dalmatian songs. They look nothing like Dalmatian people, have no Dalmatian heritage, and live on the opposite side of the world. But they are so popular with the locals and Croatian diaspora around the world. Most of the time, people are happy to share their culture with others, especially when other people genuinely embrace and enjoy it. If anyone's interested, https://yautu.buwqrl/redies. My family has two lentil soup recipes that were butted down. One is my family's original lentil soup recipe, and the other is an Indian lentil soup, because my great-grandma was married to an Indian man, and while they did eventually divorce, that recipe was still butted down as well. I don't know if this is necessarily conservative, but I'm somewhat pro-nuclear energy. I think harnessing nuclear energy could help slow the speed of climate change. It's obviously not great, since it still produces terrible waste, but I don't think it's as bad as fossil fuels, and there's a lot of room for growth and improvement in nuclear energy. Eco-nuts who think we can solve everything with only wind and solar power aren't being realistic. They are coming up with ways to recycle the waste. Look at France, for example. They are almost exclusively powered by nuclear plants and have almost no waste. As technology becomes better and better, I believe that there won't be any waste in the future. Nuclear is the way. I agree. Nuclear energy could be one of the cornerstones of sustainable development. Voted Democrat since 2000 when I turned voting age. Left-wing witch hunts and cancel culture are weakening the party, and more important things like environmental issues and maybe turning off centrist voters. Bonus frickery. Latinx is the biggest piece of linguistic colonialism masquerading as wokeness. There is, I know, zero Latinos and or Spanish speakers that agree with it. A la chingada con esa mierda. I really don't get why they insist on saying Latinx when they could just leave it at Latin people or say Latin Americans. Unless there's something wrong about saying either one of those, they seem like alternatives that could have been used instead of using a new term. As a very socially progressive Brazilian, hard agree on the Latinx thing. And you know what's funny? You can tell Latinx is a Western invention because if actual Latinos had come up with it, we'd have gone with the painfully obviously Latin. Which, honestly, I wouldn't even be opposed to. I know this can be a big deal to non-binary folks, but Latinx is horrific and has no reason to exist, other than for Westerners to jerk each other off over how great and supportive they are. We shouldn't cater, I'd say pander, to a minority by changing how another language works. I despise Latinx because it's so ethnocentric and I only hear Americans say it because any old Latino would know that Latino, despite being a masculine word, is used as though it's gender neutral in many cases. I won't act like I know how French works because Spain is in the same alliance as France. Learn about how the language works first. If you're really picky about it, just say Hispanic or Latin. Both work. I Latino.